Hi, I'm Danya Krishnamurthy, Program Manager in Azure Active Directory team. Today, I'm going to be talking about an exciting feature that we just public previewed. It's called the Azure AD Logs in Azure Monitor Diagnostics. Our customers have been asking us to provide long-term retention and ability to integrate with your SIEM tools or custom applications for a while. This is our way of providing that feature asked to you. This particular feature provides three awesome capabilities that you can leverage today. The first one is archiving the data to a storage account, which means basically you can route these logs to your own storage account with a simple configuration. Secondly, you can send these logs to Event Hub for integration, where many SIEM tools have third-party connectors that connect to them. You can also route these logs to Event Hub and hook it up with your own custom applications. Thirdly, we can send these logs to Log Analytics, where you can actually use custom queries to write advanced queries, as well as create your own custom alerts and manage them. The work to do for Log Analytics is not going to be available for the next few months, but the archiving to the storage account and sending it to the Event Hub is available as part of public preview. Now, let's jump into a demo. We are in the Azure AD extension blade. In order to get to this particular feature, you can either go into the sign-in logs or the audit logs. In this example, I'm going into the audit logs. There's an export data setting buttons, which is available for exporting this configuration. This button will be available for global admins and security admins. So as you can see here, you're taken to a blade called Diagnostic Settings. In order to get to this blade, you need to have an Azure subscription. The reason for this is you need to either have a storage account or an Azure Event Hub in order to route these logs. You need a destination. So you need to have that set up before you come and perform this configuration. So in my case, I have this particular settings where I'm routing these logs to both a storage account and an Event Hub, as you can see here. I'm selecting the two types of logs, audit and sign-ins. I can select the retention days. What this means is I can either say, hey, send me all the data up to 180 days, or I can say, keep it forever. And in this instance, I'm just setting it to zero, which means from the time the data gets routed, it'll just keep routing until I go and stop it. I can also go in here and change my storage account if I want to change it to something else. I can also go and change my Event Hub settings depending on how I want to do them. Or if you're setting it up for the first time, you'll go and select the Event Hub from where you want to stream these logs to your SIEM tool. So once you've done this, you save it. Within 2 to 10 minutes, this data will be available in your storage account and Event Hub. So let's go to the storage account that I have here. So when you go into the blob, you will see that there are two containers, audit and sign-ins. The sign-in stream is stored here and the audit stream is stored in the audit container. So I'm going to go into the sign-in stream here. You will see the tenant ID for which you've done the configuration. You will see a year, month and date format where that's how the blob is stored. So you go into one specific day, pick a specific hour where it's stored, and then just open the JSON to see the format of it. So this is the JSON format in which the logs are stored. As you can see here, we have a properties bag under which most of the attributes are stored. We have added to the same schema as the MS Graph schema for easier reference. So you can look at the MS Graph API reference doc to understand what are all the properties that we emit for sign-ins. You can also route this information to a Splunk tool. So in this example, we have used Splunk as our SIEM integration. And what we have done there is gone in and provided a Splunk integration for the logs. We have an Azure Monitor add-on for Splunk, which we have used, and we have updated that to include two set of streams. When you go to the source types, once you've set it up, you will see that there's audit and sign-ins available here. All you need to do is download the add-on for Splunk, set up the configuration to point to the Event Hub where you've routed these logs, and then when you open Splunk, you will see these two streams available. So you can click on the sign-in stream here, for example, and you will see all the logs available in the JSON format that I just showed you previously. If you click on the properties, you will see all the additional information that I showed you through the UX, through the API, which is also available here. And using Splunk, you can build visualizations and dashboards on top of this data and use it for your operational needs. This is how easy it is to set this up, and it'll just take a few minutes for you to set up the whole thing once you have the Event Hub and storage account set up. The other SIEM tools that we have integration with are Curator and Sumo Logic. You can find documentation available online to see how you can integrate them.